got a good idea. We're not going to do that. See, we have to have someone who's talented, attractive, can sing. Not you, Dad. No, back up.
Haley!
Yes! Haley! Yes!
Oh,
yes!
You know I got this.
Oh, yeah. All
right.
Making my way downtown, walking fast, faces pass, and I'm homebound. Staring blankly ahead, just making my way through the crowd.
What I need you to do is
and I need you, and I miss you, and now I wonder if I could fall into the sky. Do you think time would pass me by? 'Cause you know I'd walk 1,000 miles if I could just see you tonight. You know it's times like these when I think of you, and I wonder if you ever think of me. 'Cause everything's so wrong and I don't belong living in your precious memories. And I need you, and I miss you, and now I wonder if I could fall into the sky. Do you think time would pass me by? 'Cause you know I'd walk 1,000 miles if I could just see you tonight. And I don't wanna let you go. I drown in your memory. I don't wanna let you know. I don't. Making my way downtown, walking fast, faces pass, and I'm homebound. Just staring blankly ahead, making my way through the crowd. And I still need you, and I still miss you. And now I wonder if I could fall into the sky. Do you think time would pass me by? 'Cause you know I'd walk 1,000 miles if I could just see you. If I could fall into the sky, do you think time would pass me by? 'Cause you know I'd walk 1,000 miles if I could just see you. If I could just hold you tonight.
Day.
Oh, tell me about it. I hate Valentine's Day.
Guys, help me out on this one. It's the worst for the guys because we got to plan the perfect date. We got to buy the roses. We got to buy the dinner. We got to buy the chocolates and the gift. Guys, is that very true?
Oh, please. Ladies, we have to look nice. We have to do our hair. We have to buy new clothes. All to impress you. Yeah, not worth our time, is it, ladies?
Well, while we try and figure this out, how about we have Kevin Huizinga sing a little bit about love with his song, Being Alive.
Really good, really.
relaxed.
Watch out. Watch out.
You sounded really relaxed.
Like I was. Relaxed. I love me.
Someone to hold you too close. Someone to hurt you too deep. Someone to sit in your chair to ruin your sleep. Someone to need you too much. Someone to know you too well. Someone to pull you up short to put you through hell. Someone you have to let in. Someone whose feelings you spare. Someone who, like it or not, will want you to share a little, a lot. Someone to crowd you with love. Someone to force you to care. Someone to make you come through. Will always be there, as frightened as you of being alive. Being alive. Being alive. Being alive. Somebody hold me too close. Somebody hurt me too deep. Somebody sit in my chair and ruin my sleep and make me aware of being alive. Being alive. Being alive. Somebody need me too much. Somebody know me too well. Somebody pull me up short and put me through hell and give me support for being alive. Make me alive. Make me alive. Make me confused. Mark me with praise. Let me be used. Very mind is but alone. Somebody force me to care. Somebody let me come through. I'll always be there, as frightened as you, to help us survive. Being alive. Being alive. Being alive.
A gangsta!
You're all blue on your...
A gangsta!
Do you even know what a gangster is?
Yeah!
That is
tape on your glasses.
Oh, maybe I got the terminology wrong.
No.
I'm a wangsta.
A
white gangsta.
Oh my gosh.
What?
You're wearing suspenders.
Yeah!
Are you kidding me?
That's...
No?
No, not at all.
No, not even close.
Oh.
No. You should be ashamed of yourself.
Why can't I get anything right?
You
want?
Like,
how about we let the real people do this? Let's have the Chill and Dance group come out.
That is disgusting.
Ugly. Look at you right now.
One.
It's tight. All right.
One.
Get
two.
That outfit.
One, two, three, four. Man.
back up, come back up. Something gets smacked up, go down the clock. You know what I'm about, and you'll be calling me out. Go Capone.
I don't know how that, I can't understand them. I don't know, oh jeez.
Ooh, these heels are awful. Should I move this before? I'm so glad you changed. You look actually like a normal person now.
Haley, what are you doing?
I'm sitting on a box.
Why?
Yeah, well, I can see that.
This box is my temporary home.
Are you homeless?
No, it's temporary.
Oh yeah.
It's like the song, the next song, Temporary Home.
Oh!
Oh, yeah!
What Becca Lynn is singing.
Yeah, no.
Yeah.
Okay.
All right, so now here we have Becca Lynn singing Temporary Home.
She looks lovely. Just wait till you see her dress. It's really long and white. Oh, there she is! Love you, babies.
Yep.
Little boy, 6 years.
thou Haleth.
What are you doing?
I'm using Spakespeare.
Spakespeare wasn't a person? I think you might mean Shakespeare.
Right. Shakespeare. Right.
Yeah, he was definitely a person. Spakespeare, not so much.
No. Well, I should probably stop making a fool of myself. Yeah. How about we just let Desiree perform her oral inter piece of The Three Little Pigs with a Shakespearean twist?
You are probably wondering why I called you all here today. The answer is pigs.
Such a rush.
In time past, though not long ago, there lived pigs. In stature, little. In number, three. Who, being of an age, inspired and entitled to seek their fortune, did set about to do thusly. Shakespeare was said to have a working vocabulary of over 27,000 words. The average American, about 4,000. While we can say we've improved in many ways, our vocabulary is not one of them. A Triune Tale of Diminutive Swine by John Branham. When they had traveled the distance, pig numbered first spake, saying, "Hearken, brethren! Heed this tempestuous realm! Tarry we long from hearth and home, we shall fare, I fear, not well." And so, being collectively agreed, but individually impelled, the diminutive swine each set about to erect for himself an abode. Pig numbered one did construct his house from straw. Pig numbered two did likewise, though rather not from straw, instead from sticks. Meanwhile, unique in his imaginings, pig numbered three did erect as his domicile, stalwart, garish, a structure made from brick and tar. Soon, there happened along, as is frequently the scenario in classic tale of protagonist pig or red-hooded child, a wolf. Carnivorous in nature, in full season, he called out to the straw ensconced swine, saying, "Pray thee, pig, grant me entrance." But pig one recalled with foreboding, "He is mad who trusts the tameness of a belly-pinched wolf," and responded immediately, "Nay, it shall not be, not by wit or whisker jowl." Prepared for this most expected response, replied immediately, "Then steel thyself, little pig. Forthwith shall I endeavor, by means of huffing and puffing, to dismantle yon flaxen fortress." Whereupon there issued forth from the wolf an exhale of gale proportions that quickly rendered straw hovel to dregs and dross, and carried aloft piglet and shattered quarters both. Exposed now to claw and fang, piglet one made haste, wolf in pursuit, to the stick festooned sanctum of peccary secondary, causing pig two to cry out in dismay, "Well, this knocks my knickers. The marshalling of feral wolf to my doorstep is nowhere among those endeavors amendable or congenial. A thousand pardons! To it seem the beast's maneful breath has purged me of home and sound judgment alike." The mighty maelstrom of the wolf's exhale splat second wine shack and shortened his sanctimonious scolding simultaneously. Lo and behold, stand we now amid wooden wreckage, tremulous and vulnerable, with nary a strategy for eschewing the canine devourer looming in deadly proximity. Strategy! While 'tis noble to contemplate tactical particularities, pressed as we are with the time restraint, forbidding detailed strategical conversations, I would urge we run! Whether by their own fleet-footed competence or the wolf's windless attitude, The diminutive swine arrived at their ultimate neighbor's inexpugnable brick ingress unscathed. Upon the third pig's door, there is naught to be gained across an external opponent, save her own immediate demise. Yo, whoa, whoa, what did you just say about my mama? House and occupants were again engulfed in a malevolent blast of wolfish wind. The foundation shook, the frame rattled, and lo, to the astonished eyes of piglet and encroached scoundrel alike, stood the third pig's lodging undaunted. Aghast and dismayed, pig two queried of three, how, against such relentless and torrential onslaught, this domicile endure? Pig three puffed out chest, tapped a to the hearth, and responded, it's American made.
The three little pigs, and you know, see, we believe in realism. We believe in realism when raising a child.
The world is real.
The big bad wolf came up to the door and he said, hey, little pig, let me in. Hey, Paige,
yeah.
What did the wolf say? What did the wolf do when they let the pigs in?
They made
the wolf
bacon.
Ate all the pigs.
They
it was
made bacon,
great.
Right?
She cried for hours.
Hey, honey, I got you some lunch.
Have you guys seen that new Pitch Perfect movie?
I love that movie.
Oh, so good.
So
especially
good.
When they sing Titanium.
Oh, that's a great
movie. Oh, a burrito. No, Kunkel.
I love that movie. Grandpa, not the burrito!
Your grandpa just threw a burrito at me.
Grandpa,
I
did the
shot!
Oh, there it is.
What?
At least you don't have herpes. Or do you have those as well?
I don't
this
have
this isn't
no,
a burrito. It's an enchilada.
Nice job, Grandpa.
You
have
a burrito.
Now, Clarissa Peterson and Anna Budol with Titanium.
Thank you.
guys. After all the hardships we've had during this variety show and getting thrown with burritos, Grandpa thinks.
Sorry.
That was not nice.
I'm gonna carry it away.
I feel like we've gotten off to a bad start and we should start over.
Yeah.
The truth is, I do love you guys and I'm gonna really miss you next year.
It's all right. We can come back next year. We can help MC.
Yeah, I can do it.
We're so not very
great.
Far. Yes. Yeah. I have so many awesome ideas, Cole.
Flamethrower.
Yeah, fog machines. Mm-hmm. More bigger fog machines. Giant fans.
Tell me about it. Tell me about it. Yes, it's going to be
so
great.
Good. Paige is so excited. Just look at her.
Oh, dear.
Oh, my God. Well, here's Ashlyn Borhave singing I Will Always Love You. Oh, my Lord.
Well, we just want to thank the unsung heroes for this variety show. We want to thank the tech who are backstage and in the booth who make this all possible.
We'd like to take a chance to thank all of the performers tonight for sharing their talents, and we'd also like to thank all of the supportive parents out in the audience, because without them, we wouldn't be here tonight.
Audience for coming out tonight and supporting the fine arts. It really means a lot to all of us.
Well, I'm gonna go get an emergency med kit because it sounds like your grandma busted her hip.
Oh,
so.
Oh, no. Yeah. Not again. Even the walk she broke. That was a lot of fun, though.
That was a good time. Yeah.
Did you guys have fun tonight?
Yeah,
I had a lot of fun.
I had lots of fun.
They had a lot of fun. Yeah.
I'm kind of worried about your grandma, though. It sounded
like she felt. She's fine. She missed bingo night. She's all good.
Pains and stuff in the air.
She takes her wig off sometimes.
Oh, that's cute. It's really cute.
It's really nice, actually. Yeah. Where did Cole go, he said?
I don't know where
What
where
was that? Did you see?
Did you? What?
What?
Well,
Who?
I don't know.
I'm kind of scared. Oh, my God, the lights.
Why are the lights coming off?
Go!
Hey! I don't know which way to go! I can't see anything. I'm in a dress!
I don't like this. Oh my God!
Let's stand up over here. Oh, I have this. Will you hold the door open? Will you hold the door open? I have this leg.
Watch out. Go back here!
Paige! They're everywhere!
guys for that awful display.
That was awesome. Did anybody get that on camera? Anyone record any of that? I'm seeing it. Yeah, that is awesome. Wow.
Treasured for generations right there.
Once again, we just want to say thank you to all of you for making this night possible. Give yourself a warm
Are those real?
Good night, everybody.